Good morning and welcome back to the channel. As you can tell, it's really early in the morning. Yeah, like I said, I've said this in other videos, the life of a landscape photographer, you don't get a lot of sleep and you get up early and you got to be out before the sun rises. This is no exception this morning. Now, is it really that early? No, this time of year is really a good time for landscape photographers to get out for sunrise, you know, because sunrise isn't till like 7:45. All right, so I actually got to sleep until 6, which really wasn't so bad. And we're about, I don't know, 20, 25 minutes now before sunrise. You know, so I'm here a little early. And where am I at? Well, I'm back at my favorite named covered bridge, Rolling Stone Covered Bridge. You know, why am I here? Well, it's August or October. I think today is October 8th. 7th or 8th, I didn't look at the calendar, but it's 7th or 8th. You know, and the colors are starting to change around, and I wanted to get out here to at least try to get a picture when the leaves are starting to change. Just getting ready here in the next week or so to head off down south to the Great Smoky Mountain National Park. You know, so I'm not going to have a chance over the next couple weekends, so I figured I better get out here now while I can. I'm not sure as the sun comes up if we're going to have much in the way of color. All right, not sure we're going to get that, but you know, we'll take a look, see what we can. We're going to try to get it, at least capture an image or two. We'll talk a little bit about it as we're doing it once we get enough light. All right, and hopefully we'll be able to capture something. Hopefully it'll be something here on the trees or on the leaves. I'm sure something, it'll be different than obviously when we were here, I don't know, what was about 6 weeks ago when it was nice and green and, you know, basking in the summer sun, but you won't see that this morning. This morning it's barely above freezing. It's I think 33 or 34 degrees. So it's definitely a chilly morning and definitely falls in the air. So stick around, stay tuned. All right, so I don't know how much you can see here behind me, but you know, the light is starting to come up and there is some color in the trees. Certainly not anywhere near peak or anything like that, but still a little bit of color, so that's a good thing. So we'll take a couple images here and see how they turn out. But you know, just a reminder when you're out doing this stuff, all right, especially when you're trying to photograph something like a covered bridge, and I've talked about this in a couple of my other videos, but I want to reinforce it again. All right, be aware of the property that surrounds the bridge. Be cognizant of that and don't violate, don't trespass on somebody's private property. You know, if that means you got to stand, you know, basically on the side of the road, you know, and it limits your potential, you know, compositions, it is what it is. All right, you need to make sure you're aware of that. Now, like in this situation here where I'm at, I've got private property here on this side, private property here on this side, and it's the same on the other side of the bridge. So there's really, basically you're limited to the road, but you can find a way to still make a great image. You just have to play around with a little bit, wait for the right light, get the right time of year, you know, but certainly be aware of what's around you from a property standpoint and don't violate any of those rules. Be good and don't do that. All right. It's just, it's not something I want to encourage people to do. I want you to get out there and not break the law and still try to get a great image. All right. So I'm going to take a couple images here. We'll talk about it here maybe as I'm doing it. So let's get into it. So now when you're doing something like this, especially when it's a long exposure, like right now on this light, I'm running about a 13 second shutter speed. Make sure you have your camera set on a delay. I've got it set, you know, at 2 seconds. So that way it gets a chance for the camera to stop vibrating and you get a good sharp image. Don't forget to do that. All right, so let's talk about composition for a minute, especially when you're, again, when you're limited and where you can stand and what you can do. Because again, as you look out here, you know, along the bridge here, you can't, all this stuff on either side, That is private property, so I'm pretty much limited to the road that you see in the middle. All right, so you got to try to find yourself a composition while you're doing that, and it is not sometimes an easy task. So what I've chosen to do here is basically I'm on the left-hand side of the road, all right, and I'm hoping that by, you know, I've zoomed in some, all right, and you got the tree off here to the right, you know, and then basically the side of the road here on the left, using those as leading lines into the bridge. Now you can take the picture just like it is here, all right, and you'll be just fine. All right, you can also add a foreground element, like throw yourself out there in front of it. Okay, you can do that. All right, and I will do that here in an image, and I'll put it in during this video so you can see where I'm going to use myself standing out in front of the bridge basically as a foreground element to help draw your attention into the bridge. Now, why have I chosen this side of the bridge versus the other? As you can see, there it's not a lot of color, right? It's kind of brown and kind of yellowish, you know, just starting to fade out up above the bridge. But the sun is setting or rising almost behind me. So as it comes up, hopefully it'll illuminate some of this stuff as it gets high enough in the air to where it'll be able to maybe light up the trees and maybe I'll catch some light on that. If not, it's still just the light itself as it's coming up is giving you the ability to see, you know, the white of the tree along with the changes of the colors in the leaves. So you got the contrast of the lighter colors along with the darker greens, you know, it gives you just a little bit of a look. So that's kind of how I try to do this stuff. Now, one of the things, you know, people do ask is, you know, like you got the signs over here on the right, you know, the weight limit 5 tons. You know, a lot of people take and they Photoshop that out. I don't. I prefer, you know, to take the image for what it is and show it for what is there. It's just a personal preference. Again, it's my style. You can develop your style and do it however you want, but that's pretty much how I do it. So, I thought I'd take a chance here to answer a question I've gotten a couple times from a couple folks that don't quite understand or are not really aware of where covered bridges came from or why bridges are covered. And that's a question I've gotten a few times. All right, so why is a bridge covered? All right. So when these bridges were built, and this one, as you can see here, built in 1950, and it's still in use today, with, you know, can handle up to 5 tons, which is certainly, you know, my truck or more, all right, which is a great thing. So over 100 years old and still able to use it. So why were the bridges covered? Or why are there so many covered bridges, not only in this area? There's 9 here in Putnam County, 32, you know, in the county next door, which is Park County. All right, so why are there so many, not only in Indiana, but in other places in the country? Well, the reason was because the building materials they were using at the time, all right, were wood, all right, wood rots. So how do you protect the wood? Well, you build a cover over it. All right, and you put a roof over it, kind of enclose it, maintain it, you know, and the bridge will last a long time or, you know, contain or keep its structural integrity. And here you are today, more than 100 years later, and you can still drive across it. And that's the main reason why, you know, there are covered bridges. All right, now today, obviously, you build them out of steel and other things, so, you know, you don't really need the cover. It's more of a decoration if you find one where they do that. But back in the day, out here in the country, you know, when they didn't have a lot of steel, they went by what the farmers had and what we had around, which is a lot of trees. And so they built wooden covered bridges across something like you got here, Big Walnut Creek. All right, so I'm going to end the video here. Thank you for coming along. Hopefully, you've enjoyed a little bit of this. Remind everybody, like, comment, subscribe, try to help, you know, grow the algorithm or get us, you know, more attention through the algorithms of YouTube. Be greatly appreciated if you do that, you know, and, you know, always remember, get outside, enjoy life. Don't spend your morning lying in bed, you know, trying to figure out what you're going to do for the day. Just get up, go out and take some pictures, you know, if nothing else, or just breathe some nice, fresh country air like you have this morning. All right, so thanks for your time, everybody, and until we see you again, stay safe.